مائک نمبر ایک پر اگر کوئی غیر مسلم بھائی ہیں تو اپنا سوال کر سکتے ہیں. مائک نمبر ایک سے.
السلام علیکم.
وعلیکم السلام.
میرا نام روی شنکر رام ہے, میں کلکتہ سے آیا ہوں, اور سب سے پہلے آپ کو شکریہ دینا چاہتا ہوں. آپ سے ملنے کا تمنا بہت دنوں سے تھی, کیونکہ میں نے پیسٹ بھی بہت لگاتار دیکھتا ہوں گھر پر. آپ کا جو سبھیتا, جو شسٹاچار میں نے جو دیکھا, میں اپنے آپ کو روک نہیں پایا. اس لیے میں آپ سے امپریس ہو کے یہاں پر آیا ہوں. اور سر میرا سوال ہے کہ ایک دھارمک انسان کی پہچان, اس کی لکشن ہندو مت کے انوسار جیسے دھرم کے دکش لکشن ہوتے 10 دھیتی, کھما, دم, استے, سوچ, اندریہ نگرہ, بدھی, ودیا, ست اور سنتوش. یہ دھرم کے 10 لکشن ہے. اگر کوئی بھی دھارمک انسان میں یہ لکشن پائے جاتے ہیں تو انسان دھارمک ہے. میرا سوال ہے سر کہ اسلام کے انوسار, اسلام دھرم کے انوسار ایک دھارمک انسان کا پہچان کیا ہے, میں یہ جاننا چاہتا ہوں.
بھائی صاحب کا سوال ہے کہ اسلام کے نزدیک ایک دھارمک انسان کی پہچان کیا ہے. اسلام کے نزدیک جو خدا, بھگوان, ایشور, اللہ جو فرماتے ہیں, جو کہتے ہیں, اس کے اوپر عمل کریں گے تو آپ دھارمک ہیں. اور اللہ تعالیٰ فرماتے ہیں کہ اطیع اللہ و اطیع رسول, اللہ کی بات مانو اور اللہ کے رسول کی بات مانو. تو اگر آپ قرآن پہ عمل کریں گے اور قرآن کے صحیح حدیث پہ عمل کریں گے تو آپ دھارمک ہو گئے. اس کے اندر کچھ چیز آپ دیکھے جائے تو اسلام کے اندر 5 حصوں میں بانٹی جا سکتی ہے. ایک ہے فرض, کمپلسری, یہ کرنا ہی چاہیے ہر مسلمان کو, فرض آ گیا. دوسرے اور حرام, جو غلط ہے آپ کرنا ہی نہیں چاہیے زندگی میں, یہ دونوں اپوزٹ ہے. اس کے درمیان اور 3 چیزیں جو حلال کیٹیگری میں, حرام کے علاوہ سب چیز حلال ہو جاتی. حلال میں 4 کیٹیگری, ایک ہے فرض جو کرنا چاہیے کمپلسری, دوسرا ہے مستحب یا لوگ کہتے سننا, یعنی کرے تو بہتر ہے, آپ کو پلس پوائنٹ ملیں گے. تیسرا ہے مباح, آپشنل, کرے تو بھی کوئی حرج نہیں, نہیں کرے تو بھی حرج نہیں. چوتھا ہے مکروہ, یعنی نہیں کرے تو بہتر ہے. اور پانچواں جیسے میں نے کہا حرام. تو ایک دھارمک انسان کوشش کرے گا کہ 100% کم از کم فرائض تو کرے اور حرام نہ کرے. تو منیمم ریکوائرمنٹ ہے کہ وہ 100% جو فرض ہے وہ کرے اور جو حرام ہے وہ کچھ بھی نہ کرے. اور دھارمک بننا چاہیں گے تو جو مستحب ہے, جو انکریج ہے, جو سنت ہے, اس کے اوپر عمل کرے. جتنا زیادہ عمل کریں گے اتنا دھارمک ہوگا. اور جتنے مکروہ ہے, جو چیز اوائڈیبل ہے, ڈسکریج ہے, اس سے دور رہیں گا. ان شارٹ, اگر آپ قرآن اور صحیح حدیث پہ عمل کریں گے تو آپ اسلام میں دھارمک کہلائیں گے. ہوپ دیٹ آنسرز دی کوسچن. بھائی صاحب آپ پیس ٹی وی کتنے سال سے دیکھ رہے ہیں؟
سر پیس ٹی وی تو پہلے دیکھا تھا میں نے 6 مہینہ پہلے, اس کے بعد میں پھر بند ہو گیا تھا. تو اس کے بعد میں نے چیلنج ایک دن رات کو میں آن کر رہا تھا تو چینل پھر ایک بار پیس ٹی وی آیا تھا, تو میں نے لگاتار پیس ٹی وی رات 9:45 قریب آپ کا تقریر آتا تھا وہاں پر, تو میں نے دیکھتے تھے. اس کے بعد میں پھر وہ بند اپنے آپ بند ہو گیا تھا.
بھائی صاحب آپ مانتے کہ خدا ایک ہے؟
جی سر.
مانتے خدا ایک ہے؟
جی.
آپ مانتے خدا کا کوئی عکس ہے؟
نہیں سر.
خدا کا عکس نہیں. خدا کی کوئی مورتی ہے؟
نہیں سر.
آپ مانتے مورتی پوجا غلط ہے؟
جی سر.
آپ مانتے بت پرستی غلط ہے؟
جی سر.
آپ مانتے کہ محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم آخری پیغمبر ہے؟
جی سر.
آپ مانتے, تو اس کا مطلب جو اسلام کی بیسک.
جی سر, کل ہم پروگرام دیکھے تھے جس طرح آپ کلکی اوتار کے بارے میں ورنن کیے تھے.
جی ہاں.
تو ہم لوگ بھی کلکی پران, رگ وید, کلکی پران میں اور رگ وید اور سب بک کے بارے میں آپ بتا رہے تھے کل, تو میں بھی نہیں جانتا تھا اس بارے میں.
تو ابھی آپ مانتے ہیں؟
جی سر.
خدا ایک ہے؟
جی سر.
اور خدا کے علاوہ کسی کی عبادت نہیں کرنا چاہیے؟
نہیں کرنا.
اور آپ مانتے ہیں کہ محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم آخری پیغمبر ہے؟
جی سر.
تو منیمم ریکوائرمنٹ ہے اسلام دھرم میں دھارمک ہونے کے لیے, منیمم.
جی سر.
منیمم پاسنگ مارک, پاسنگ مارک یہ ہے, جسٹ پاس. بعد میں اس کے بعد عمل جتنا کرتے رہیں گے تو انشاءاللہ. تو آپ چاہتے ہیں کہ مسلم بنے؟
جی سر.
آپ چاہتے ہیں؟
جی سر.
کوئی بھی آپ پہ زبردستی کر رہا ہے؟
نو سر.
वाकई नहीं, जबरदस्ती नहीं कर रहे ना
नहीं।
आप मेरी मोहब्बत में आ गए, मेरी मोहब्बत ने आपको कलकत्ता से किशनगंज खींच लाया, क्योंकि मैं आपको कोई जबरदस्ती नहीं कर रहा हूँ ना।
नो सर,
आप अपने मन से
जी सर
और आपके दिमाग से होशो आवाज में इस्लाम कबूल करना चाहते हैं
जी सर,
तो इंशाल्लाह मैं अरबी में कहूंगा, आप उसे दोहराइए इंशाल्लाह। अशदु
अशदु
अल्लाह
अल्लाह
इलाहा
इलाहा
इल्लल्लाह
इल्लल्लाह
व अशदु
व अशदु
अन्ना
अन्ना
मुहम्मदन
मुहम्मदन
अब्दुहु
अब्दुहु
व रसूलुहु
व रसूलुहु।
मैं शहादत देता हूँ,
शहादत देता हूँ कि
अल्लाह के अलावा
अल्लाह के अलावा
कोई माबूद नहीं,
कोई माबूद नहीं,
और मोहम्मद
मोहम्मद
सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम उसके
पैगंबर
और बंदे हैं। माशाल्लाह, आप मुसलमान हो चुके, और मैं अल्लाह से दुआ करूंगा कि इंशाअल्लाह आपको सबसे बेहतरीन जिंदगी दे इस दुनिया में और आखिरत में भी, और अल्लाह ताला आपको और हिदायत दे ताकि और आप अमल कर सके। और जो आपकी ख्वाहिश है कि आप इस्लाम में और धार्मिक बने, मेरी इल्तिजा आपसे कि आप इंशाल्लाह कुरान मजीद का तर्जुमा पढ़िए, वो जबान में जो जबान पे आपको महारत है, हिंदी में तो हिंदी में पढ़िए, बंगाली में तो बंगाली में पढ़िए, और इंशाल्लाह इसके ऊपर अमल कीजिए। और कोई अगर आपको शक और शुबा है तो इंशाल्लाह आप ईमेल लिख सकते हैं zakir@irf.net में।
थैंक यू सर,
जज़ाकअल्लाह शुक्रिया,
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया।
Hi, my name is Rahul. I'm a banker by profession. I just wanted to ask you one thing. Like, ever since I have the sense of religion, we have heard that God is one, and we are hearing it again as the God is one. But just now we had two people going as per you call Shahada award. What you call is there is no God except Allah. And continuing what did you just tell Mr. Rajesh, that whatever religion which came into existence before Islam, this Islam corrected these some ways out of this and some way out of that, that there were some mistakes in the religions before Islam, and Islam corrected the things, and the messenger, the last messenger what you're just talking about, he corrected them all, and now you have to follow the things again. So are you denying the fact that there was no God except Allah before Islam? Like there is no Lord Shiva, there was no Lord Ganesha as per Hinduism or as per something. So are you totally denying the fact according to Islam? So as you say, there is no God except Allah?
Whereas
we say, God is one.
The brother asked a very good question. He said that when I say and I give the Shahada that there is no God but Allah and Prophet Muhammad is a messenger, do you mean to say that Islam came and corrected? So before Islam there was no God, and that's what I mean to say, brother. There's a slight misunderstanding. Islam is not a new religion. Islam did not come into existence 1400 years back. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the founder of Islam. Islam is there since time immemorial. It is there since man set foot on the earth. And Prophet Muhammad is not the founder of the religion of Islam. He is the last and final messenger. So before Hinduism came into existence, Islam was there. And Allah clearly says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, verse 19, Inna Deena Indallah Al-Islam. The only religion acceptable in the sight of Allah is Islam. And the message is repeated in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 85, that if anyone takes any other religion besides Islam, it will never be accepted of him. He'll be amongst the losers. Meaning, there is only one religion, Islam. The first prophet was Prophet Adam. Peace be upon him. Many other prophets came. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad said there were 124,000 messengers sent on the face of the earth. By name, we know only 25 in the Quran. Adam, Abraham, Noah, Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, peace be upon them all. Now, by name, I know 25 only in the Quran. You may tell me that, don't you believe in Ram? Don't you believe in Krishna? I say, I don't know. Were they prophets of God? I say, I don't know. Maybe they were not. Because they are not mentioned in the Quran, I don't know. Maybe they were not. But all the messengers that came before the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, they were sent only for those people in that time. Their message was time bound. But because Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the last and final messenger, his message was not meant only for the Muslims or the Arabs, it is meant for the whole of humanity. That's why Quran says in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 107, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رحمت للعالمین, that we have sent thee not but as a mercy to all the creatures, as a mercy to all the worlds, as a mercy to all the human beings. Similarly, all the scriptures that came before, by name only four are mentioned in the Quran: Torah, Zabur, Injil, and the Quran. But Quran says in Surah Ra'd, chapter number 13, verse number 38, وَلِكُلِ أَجْلٍ كِتَابٍ. In every age have we sent a revelation. There were many books sent. I don't know my name. You ask me, can you call Veda the word of God? Maybe, maybe not. But even if it's the word of God, all the scriptures that came before the Quran, they were meant only for those people in that time. Now, because there was time bound, Almighty God did not think it fit to preserve it. Now, because Quran is the last and final revelation, Quran, when it was revealed about 14 years back, it was not sent only for the Muslims or the Arabs, it was sent for the whole of humanity. Quran says in Surah Ibrahim chapter 14 verse number 1, in Surah Ibrahim chapter 14 verse 52, in Surah Zumur chapter 39 verse 41, that the Quran was sent for the whole of humanity. It was not sent only for the Muslims and Arabs. So today...
No, but I think we are not talking about the humanity, we are talking about the Islam. That Islam is totally denying the fact that there is no God except Allah.
Correct.
What I'm trying to say outright here is, like just you just told me that it is written in Quran, that it may not be written in Quran, or it is not written in Quran, that there were some ways, there were some scriptures written or not. So it means there was a mistake by the writers, or by the scholars or
Correct.
Scriptures of the Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, that they did not mention that there is some God existing?
Very good question. What I'm telling you, if you heard my answer correctly, you'll understand. I said all the scriptures that came before, because they were not meant to be followed till eternity, God did not think it fit to preserve it. If you heard my answer, there were many scriptures, by name I know only four. But because they're not supposed to be followed today, why should I do research on it?
So by this you are meaning that there was no Ramayana, there was no Mahabharat?
I'm telling you, there were many scriptures.
But like now also, it has been proved geographically that there was proofs getting down that there was Ramayana, there was pulls, Setus, and what you have heard also
okay,
about.
Okay, you want to know about Ramayana?
No, it has been proved. I mean to say.
I will tell you the proof now.
I mean to say.
Fine, now you're asking me a question. I'm giving you information now. You are talking me about Ramayana and Mahabharata. I don't know what your knowledge is about Ramayana and Mahabharata. I'm asked, how many types of Ramayana are there?
I really don't know about
you don't
that.
Know.
I just know the basic version of the Ramayana.
You know,
we have
you,
heard of it and we have seen.
I will tell you, brother. According to Ramanuja, who's a great scholar of Ramayana, he says there are more than 300 different types of Ramayana.
Okay.
300 different types. Which one do you follow? Quran, only one. They may be sects, they may call themselves Shia, Sunni, Hanafi, Shafi'i. Only Quran is one.
So are you openly or behind the stage or behind the curtain trying to deny the fact that there is no God except Allah?
Not denying the fact, telling the fact that there was no God before Allah, there is no God before Allah, there will not be a God before Allah. But coming to your question, you fail to realize that Islam is not a new religion. Islam
no,
is there.
I have my due respect to the Quran, to the religion, Islam
Correct.
Religion. There is no doubt about the Quran. There is no doubt about the Holy Messenger and everything else.
What I'm
my only concern before the start, at the end of the session, the only concern was, are we denying the fact that there is no God except Allah? So you are totally saying that there is Hindus have no lords.
No. Even Hinduism says the same thing, brother.
That's what I'm saying.
Even Hinduism says, Na tasya patima asti. Of that God, there is no image. Yet you make a statue of God and call him Ram. You make a statue of Krishna and call him God. You make a statue of Brahma. Why?
But that is a sentimental sort
not
of thing.
Sentimental,
we cannot challenge the sentiments of the beliefs.
Not challenge. By challenging the sentiment, if you are going against the instruction of your creator, you are not obeying him. You cannot say, I'm sentimental, therefore I'm to kill anyone. I'm sentimental, I'm to insult anyone.
No, but
you are insulting God.
But instructor never told us also this thing that you cannot pray me by creating my idol or something
it
like that.
It is mentioned.
This is the internal sentiment of the
not internal.
Follower.
It is mentioned in Yajurved, chapter number 32, verse number 3.
What?
Don't make an image of Almighty God. And you're making. So you're going against the commandment of your scripture, not my scripture. Your scripture.
But
what I'm going to tell you, that if you call yourself a Hindu, which Hindu? A Hindu who believes in Vedas. A Hindu who believes in Mahabharata. You are talking about scientific thing. If I talk about scientific thing, do you know Mahabharata? Mahabharata was a story told by the grandfather of Arjun. Initially, Mahabharata contained only 8,000 shlokas. Later on, it contained 24,000 shlokas. Today it contains more than 100,000. Where did it come from? Moment the story was told generation down generation, they kept on adding their family members as heroes. So today's scholar says the original Mahabharat, which was a story told between the feud between two families, exactly, Pandavas and Kauravas, was 8,000 verses. Today it's 100,000. Where did the 92,000 come from?
No, I think we swayed away from what we were discussing.
Not swayed away. So therefore, me as a scientific person will tell you, this Mahabharat has got interpolation, has a concoction, has a corruption. Not me. The Hindu scholars say that. The Hindu scholars, if you read, they say it's an interpolation, not Dr. Zakir. I read their books, but I'm enlightening you. Your Pandit may not be telling you. And what I'm telling you, you're talking Mahabharat. You know Kurukshetra. Do you know where Kurukshetra is today?
Yeah.
Do you know how big it is?
Yeah.
How big? Your Mahabharat tells that there are Akshahoni. From when he started from morning till night, he was keeping on riding the chariot. And there were 13 Akshahoni. Each Akshahoni contains about 100,000 elephants and few hundred thousand horses. You know the Kurukshetra is so small. Where can it fit? Suppose I tell you in this hall, 1 million people came for my lecture. You will tell Dr. Zakir Naik is a fool.
I think that Kurukshetra has been geographically attained the name of Kurukshetra now.
Brother.
At that time, the whole area was called as Kurukshetra. So
brother,
I think.
Have you read Mahabharat?
I've not read, but I have heard of it.
This is the problem. You have heard. I have read. I am giving you reference. I am a person who is a medical doctor. I am telling you, brother, you have diabetes, don't touch sugar. But I've heard somewhere having sugar is good for diabetes. I said, brother.
No, I was giving you answer for what you said, that 1 million horses cannot be mounted in this small arena or whatever. I said,
not horses. Not horses. Horses don't come to listen to my lecture.
I'm sorry to everybody else otherwise.
You are calling the audience horses.
No. My answer was to you like that time. The Kurukshetra was not defined as an area.
It was
the whole
defined.
The whole area is defined in the
Mahabharat. Anyways. The area is defined. The boundaries are given.
Today, if you find out,
not bound, even in the scriptures. The scripture says what it is.
I mean geographical location.
Yeah, geographical location. The scripture says.
I know this
what
place
was
because only 50 miles away from my hometown.
From your home, but do you know your scripture? Your scripture is miles away from your mind.
Anyways, I think we are swearing off from what we were discussing. So.
Not swaying, I'm telling you scientifically, if you do research, you come to know there is so much of concoction. There's so much of. I'm not here to criticize your scripture. Now, because you're talking about scientific proof and logic, I'm coming to that. My question to you is, Islam is there since time immemorial. So where is the question of before Islam?
No.
Before Islam, there were no human being. When human being came, Islam came. So where is the question of saying before Islam?
I think this is a matter
of. So your knowledge of Islam is less. You may think Islam came into existence 1400 years back. You know Hinduism, Hindu scriptures, the scholars say, majority say, Hindu scriptures came into existence 4000 years back. Islam did not come 4000 years back. Islam is there since time immemorial. We don't know how many years, millions and millions of years. So for you to say before Islam, before God is before also there was no God but Allah. Today also there is no God but Allah. Even after millions and billions of years afterwards, there is no God but Allah.
So this is just a matter of belief among all the religions. So as I believe,
all the religions, including Hinduism, this is the belief. Including Christianity, this is the belief. Including Islam, this is the belief.
No, including Hinduism, this is the belief that God is one. I never say that there is no God except Lord Shiva or Lord Ram. That was my concern. Thank you very much.
No, but Lord Shiva is not God. Lord Shiva is avatar. If you say messenger, I've got no problem. But the moment you say God, Lord Shiva is a different God, Krishna is a different God, Ram is a different God, that means you're going against your scripture saying that ikkam ividityam. God is only one without a second. So what I realize, your knowledge, because being limited, you are telling me as a medical doctor, if I'm telling you, you have diabetes, there's problem in your pancreas, etc. Have less sugar. No. I've read, you know, sugar is good for energy, calories. Aray, bhai, it is poison for you. No. I say, what can I do?
Thank you very much for your so kind answers.
And I pray to Allah
to
guide you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.